Goldman Sachs has a supposed superstar portfolio that they say has beaten the S&P 500 in the last few years. So in this video, I want to break down this portfolio, reveal all the positions in that portfolio, and kind of give you my opinion on what I think of this portfolio, what I think about these positions, and if this portfolio is sustainable moving forward. So this is going to be one of those fun portfolio review videos, and if you like these videos, drop a huge like down below. If we can get, say, 150 likes on this video, I'll create more portfolio type videos like this. Actually, who am I kidding? I'm either way gonna create those videos, but I really appreciate a like down below. Okay, now the goal of this portfolio is very simple. The only thing that they wanted to do really was outperform the S&P 500. Such an easy task, right? Something that anyone can do. Not quite, but they claim with this portfolio that they were able to do that. But the twist here with this portfolio is that they actually only picked industry-leading companies to make up this so-called superstar portfolio. Now, they haven't disclosed the allocation of each position in this portfolio. Man, how many times am I going to say portfolio in this video? But what I am going to do for this, just for simplicity's sake, is keep things simple and just have an equal weighting for all positions. So the first company on this list here is Altria, ticker symbol MO. Altria is a tobacco giant in the US, and they have been making headlines recently due to their possible merger talks with Philip Morris. Altria has a majority of the tobacco market in the US and has a big stake in Cronos for exposure to that sector and Juul to get exposure to the vaping sector. The stock has recently been flirting with breaking that 52-week low, and because of this, it's offered incredible value. The dividend yield is extremely attractive, pulling in 7.68% currently, with an impressive 10+% 5-year compounded annual growth rate and a good history of raising dividends as well. Now, if we jump to this smart score valuation here, we can see a consolidated view of information that Tipranks collects on any stock. I don't want to spend time going through all of this, but looking at this, in my opinion, Altria is screaming a buy at these levels. There's a lot more upside than downside in the stock, in my opinion. Now, I think that the stock will actually start negatively affecting this portfolio that they have built just because there's a lot of headwinds for this company and this industry really in general. But that nice dividend yield should keep things relatively stable. But I wouldn't expect massive gains of this company in the short term. The second company that we have here is Alphabet, ticker symbol G-O-O-G-L. This is one of the largest companies in the world with an extremely profitable business model. In fact, you're watching this video on one of Alphabet's platforms right now, YouTube. Now, their chart has been up, up, and away, quite the opposite of what Altria has been doing. But even at these prices, Alphabet or Google has a lot of potential upside, and this is a solid company in any portfolio, in my opinion. And we can see that hedge funds have been selling off some of the stock recently, and insiders have as well, although insider selling is fairly negligible. Tipranks sentiment has also seemed to be negative with this stock, but I wouldn't weigh that too heavily here personally. I would say that Google is currently between a neutral and a positive rating here for me personally, and I think the stock will continue to perform well and be one of the better performers in this portfolio. The next company we have here is General Electric, ticker symbol GE. And this is a company I'm not personally a big fan of. GE's charts really tell us the picture here. In a stock that went from over $30 a share to under $10 a share in just 2 years, this is a perfect example of why diversification is important. Now, Goldman Sachs may have entered this position here in GE near its bottom under $10 per share, in which case it may actually be a positive position for them. But moving forward, I don't expect much out of this stock in the near term. What's interesting though here is that its smart score shows that insiders and hedge funds have been gobbling up GE shares recently. Perhaps they know something that we don't, but that perspective of it looks bullish. However, there's still a lot this company needs to do to turn things around because right now they've lost a lot of investors' confidence and investors are just not interested in the stock anymore. And even me personally, I would not consider adding this to my portfolio. This may be one of those neutral stocks in the portfolio. I don't know if it's going to drop a lot lower. I don't know if it's going to rise a lot higher. But I do think we're probably going to continue moving sideways in the stock until something big comes out here, either in a positive light or a negative light. So in the near term, I think this will be kind of a neutral stock for the portfolio. Coming in at number four is one of my favorite companies, Disney, ticker symbol DIS. Now, I made a video in, I think, late 2018 or early 2019, covering my favorite stock for 2019, and that was Disney stock. And since that video, the stock has performed extremely well. The stock has broken out of multi-year consolidation on the excitement around Disney Plus, and it has been at or near all-time highs for the last few months. The smart score on Disney shows us a lot of green here, and rightfully so for this incredible company. News and sentiment will continue to be bullish in my opinion and positive around Disney into the launch for Disney Plus, and depending on how that goes, we may see the stock hit somewhere around $200 per share in 2020. Now, this is definitely a position that I approve of personally for this portfolio, and I think it'll be one of the stronger performers in that portfolio. Number five shifts gears a bit to a company that we all know, but isn't that exciting. That's General Motors, ticker symbol GM. Now, if you follow my channel, you know that my favorite company in the automotive space is Tesla. GM, though, is a very interesting stock because it's pretty much done nothing for the last 5 years for investors. However, they pay 4% dividend yield, and that's some income that you generate every year, even though capital appreciation has been more or less flat. The smart score, surprisingly, is looking pretty good, with a lot of positivity around the stock, but personally, I am not interested in General Motors. This may be a good stock to have in the portfolio for that consistent dividend income, but is this a company that I see doing great things in the future? Not necessarily, which is why I don't think that I personally have this in my portfolio. But for this portfolio, it may be one of the more neutral stocks, but you're still getting that dividend income. Next up is a company called CERN Corp, ticker symbol CERN. And honestly, this is not a company that I've researched a lot in depth, but it is a fairly large company at around $22 billion. Performance has been so-so in the stock, and it may continue moving sideways for the foreseeable future. And really, the smart score here for CERN is mixed, with ratings all over the place, so I would be fairly neutral here on this company at current prices. I don't really have a massive opinion here on this stock. It may be one of the better performers here just based on past experience and past performance, and I do also believe that they pay out a dividend. Let me know in the comment section down below if you know that they do or not, because I'm not too familiar with this stock. Moving on to number seven is Ford, ticker symbol F. And this is another company very similar to GM, not one that I'm very interested in. However, they do pay out a good dividend, which is what a lot of investors like holding it for. The stock has performed pretty poorly over the last few years, with it moving down and to the right. However, the current dividend yield is around 6.5%. I think this is what's keeping a lot of investors interested in the stock. And if you personally hold Ford as well in your portfolio, I think it's a risk that you're accepting that this dividend may be cut at some point. And if that does happen, the stock will take an even bigger beating than it already has. The smart score here is mixed again, with some bullish and some bearish sentiment all around. Insiders, however, are buying Ford, so there may be a sign of good things to come in this company. But we'll have to wait and see how this plays out. Again, it's one of the stocks that I think may actually underperform in the portfolio, but because of that dividend yield, it might balance things out and may be actually fairly neutral. It's kind of interesting to me how this portfolio is supposed to be all about, you know, the sector leaders, but they don't have Tesla in this portfolio, even though they're the sector leader in electric vehicles, which is the future. So that's just something that I found interesting here. They had both GM and Ford instead. All right, now we're getting to the final three stocks, and here we have Procter & Gamble, ticker symbol PG. And this is one of those stable companies that's going to be around pretty much forever. And it's one of those dividend investor dream stocks that pays out a dividend consistently and grows it year over year. If you look at the chart here for Procter & Gamble, you can see that the stock has more or less been on fire, almost doubling in about a year and a half. Now, is this company sustainable at these prices? Perhaps, but I think that at current prices, Procter & Gamble is overvalued, so I'll be waiting for a sale personally. Now, if we look at the smart score, this is kind of echoed here with insiders selling the stock and hedge funds also selling the stock. And I believe they know the stock is overvalued at these prices, and we will eventually see a correction in this stock, at which point these insiders and hedge funds will most likely flood back in. Now, this correction may not be anytime soon. The stock may continue moving higher for the near term, but these kind of moves in these large companies that don't really have that much growth is typically unsustainable. So I would not be surprised to see a correction in Procter & Gamble in the next few years. Now, that being said, I think this will be one of the stronger performers in this portfolio just because of the current economic state that we're in. These kind of stocks tend to do really well when there's times of uncertainty or a possible recession that's looming. All right, so now we're into the final two stocks. At number nine, we have UPS, ticker symbol UPS. And this is another stock that's been struggling to move anywhere in the last few years, pretty much consolidating until there's something big that comes out of this company that moves it higher or lower. The Tipranks Smart Score actually indicates that this is a very good buy right now, with greens across the board and sentiment generally bullish as well. The current PE for the stock is around 21, dividend yield is over 3%, and I tend to agree that at these current prices, UPS is a great stock to have in this portfolio. I think this will actually be one of the better performing stocks in the near term, just because it's been beaten down so badly and there's a lot of bad news already priced into the stock. So if there is some positive news that comes out, either with the economy or the industry or the company, this stock may actually have a pretty good run. So closing off the portfolio, we have one of my favorite stocks of all time. So let's get that drum roll in here. And this stock is Pepsi, ticker symbol PepsiCo. Now this is an incredibly strong performing stock, and really continues to make new all-time highs every week, so it's typically one of the best performers in any portfolio. Couple this with the low current PE of 17 and a dividend yield close to 3%, we have a strong stock that appeals to both value investors and dividend investors. And not surprisingly here, we can see the insiders and hedge funds have been selling the stock recently, which makes sense because they do tend to sell when prices move up significantly, which it has, and they will most likely rebuy on the next big correction Pepsi sees. I am a huge fan of this stock, and I think that it should be in most portfolios depending on your strategy. But for a strategy like what Goldman Sachs has kind of set out here, it's definitely going to be one of the stronger performing stocks in that portfolio. So that rounds out the portfolio, and here's another look at all the positions in that portfolio. Let me know which of these positions, if you had to pick some, you would hold in your personal portfolio, or maybe you already currently hold. And I also really want to hear if you guys think that this portfolio that they have laid out will in fact outperform the S&P 500 in the next few years. Personally, there's a lot of holdings in here that I would never personally invest in, and I don't think they really have a strong future. So because of that, I don't personally think that this portfolio will outperform the S&P 500 over the next few years, and definitely not over the long term. Guys, as always, a like is truly appreciated on every single video that you watch. Thank you so much for sticking around for the end of this video. Don't forget to check out one of my other videos, share this video with a friend, and if you're brand new here, hit that subscribe button down below as well. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to invest positively. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.